Thrivers, as you know, authentically me, Regina B, back to give you guys an update on my progress through my therapy workbooks. For those of you that are new, the workbooks that we're working through is Let That Shit Go, and it's by Monica Sweeney, and it says a journal for leaving bullshit behind and creating a happy life, or a balanced life. So that's this one. And then the other one is more serious and it's more intense. As you guys know, for those of you who don't, it's Cognitive Behavioral Therapy in 7 weeks, Retrain Your Brain, a workbook for managing depression and anxiety by Seth J. Gillihan. And I am 2 week 6, for those of you that have been keeping up with the journey, with the progress. And I actually completed week six, day six earlier today, but I'm only gonna give you guys an update on day one because I don't want the video to be too long. I'm really going to try in 2022 to shorten my videos so that, you know, the likelihood of you being able to follow along and go with the journey and watch the videos is higher if the videos are shorter. So that's what I'm gonna try to do. So let's hop right into it. And I did notice that I do have a new subscriber. I didn't see the name, so maybe they chose to be private. But shout out to you. Thank you for subscribing to the channel. Thank you for joining the journey. And thank you to all my subscribers. I greatly, greatly appreciate your love and support. And I hope that you guys are doing well and have had a good holiday. Because today is Monday, January 3rd, so the holidays are all done. Thank you, Jesus. And now we're getting into 2022. So let's go ahead and get to week six. Okay, so week six is facing your fears. And it says, so let's see, last week we addressed time and task management, including a structured plan for getting things done, as well as ways to overcome common barriers. We're now ready to tackle the final major task for this program, how to face your fears. But first, let's revisit some familiar themes from previous chapters as we see how things went over the past week. You had 3 main goals last week: continuing to complete enjoyable and important activities, addressing problematic thoughts, and working on ways to manage your time and tasks. Hopefully by now you're on a roll with your activity completion. If you continue to struggle, return to week 2 and review the principles as needed. In the space below, briefly review your successes and any challenges in this area from the past week. Towards the back, so I should be able to get to there easier. Okay, so it says, I have successfully attended 2 group spin classes, went holiday shopping, called a friend, went to a birthday dinner. Challenging thoughts seem to always come in when I'm trying something new, or whenever actually, but instead of allowing those anxious or negative thoughts to defeat me, I challenge them back by acknowledging the truth. Yes, I'm nervous about X, Y, and Z, but I'm not going to be afraid. My challenge now that I hope to overcome is overly thinking about what people are thinking about me and not caring what people think about me. Reputation. As I told you guys, I read this Enneagram book and I found where, you know, what my number is. And one of the things that they said was a value was like reputation. And I was like, no, so I really want to work on not caring about my reputation. And I prayed about it. And I know that that is something that is going to develop in me. That character trait is going to develop, not worrying about my reputation. Because again, Jesus became a man of no reputation, even though he had the highest reputation. And so he's the example that I want to live by. So if he's able to become a man of no reputation, he said, I am humble and meek. I want to be that way too. And a part of being that way is not caring what people think. So anyway, moving right along, let me put this pen in here. I'm in my salon chair in my kitchen. So, okay, so over the coming week, continue to complete activities from your list. If there are some threes you haven't gotten to, consider adding them to your schedule. Also, choose 3 days to monitor your activities using the daily activities form. In the past week, did you catch yourself thinking things that weren't supported by facts? Record the kinds of thoughts you noticed and challenged in the space below. And this is still day one. And I completed day one on December 22nd, 2 days before my birthday. My birthday was pretty cool. I turned 39. So it was low key. I really didn't want to do anything major. I could have stayed home, but it was so nice out on that day, which is not normal for this area, for the Midwest, and you know, December 24th. But we went out and we walked around this area called the Plaza, and we looked at the lights and stuff. So I wrote, definitely. I even brought one topic up to my therapist. She didn't confirm what I was thinking as fact, but validated that the situation would be unnerving to most people. The situation and the person involved is not only a different race, but also culture, being from a different country. So while validating my anxiety in regards to this situation, she also advised I look into this person's culture. I've also been praying more about it, maybe not more, but recognizing a negative thought and my frustration and praying about it. So like, I guess I have been like, oh, why did you think that way? And then I've been like, Lord, did you see, like, or, you know, Father, did you see that thought that went through my head? That's so frustrating. Like, I have that type of prayer life. Like, oh. So then it says, by now you may be at a point where you can begin to dismiss thoughts more efficiently without going through the full evidence-finding exercise. It's usually helpful to have something to say in response to the thoughts. For example, in week 4, we saw how Alex... What?
I didn't see her.
Harper, don't do that. Okay. In week 4, we saw how Alex, when she caught herself having an inaccurate thought, would say things like, someone's lying about me again. Other possibilities include... excuse me. Other possibilities include, there go my thoughts, okay, back to reality, thank goodness that's not true, not everything you think is true, which that one is one I've been practicing for a pretty long time, especially when I do like my Headspace runs with the Nike Run Club app. They have a mindful running section, and that's one thing that, and Andy Petticombe of Headspace actually has an app as well, but that's one of the things that he says about challenging our thoughts, or he says like our thoughts are like clouds. As you see them kind of float through the sky, you can acknowledge it, you know, acknowledge it and then just move on, and just know that like, just because you think it doesn't necessarily make it true, and then come back to your present moment. So it says, the options are endless. Just find something that resonates with you. In the coming week, continue to notice if and when your thoughts aren't helping you. If you can't easily dismiss a troubling thought, plan to complete a challenging your thoughts form. So it says, if you plan to complete some tasks using specific strategies for time and task management, how well did you follow the plan you laid out for yourself? Did anything go worse than expected or better? If you struggle to stick to the plan you set for yourself, what got in the way? So let's see. So I wrote, I did organize my closet and drawers. I went through and determined what to keep, store, and donate. I even gave away my Garmin 235 watch and three pairs of running shoes. I put an ad on Craigslist, not expecting a huge response, and checked back to find 8 or 9 responses. I picked a responder, a woman, and she got the items. And she was so like happy about it. She couldn't believe that it was like free. I was like, yes, it's free. And a lot of the email responses that I got were like, is the watch still available? You mean free? And I was like, yes, I mean free. And I remember like being all excited around the house, like, oh my God, it is better to give than to receive. And that was something that I really wanted to do because I didn't want that watch to go to waste. And I think it's a great watch. for tracking your runs, for tracking cycling, if you're a swimmer. It has all these different great things that you can use it for. And because I got my Apple Watch, I wasn't using it anymore. And I really wanted it to go to someone who is living an active lifestyle, that maybe wants to get into running. I wanted to give the running shoes and the watch together. And I was able to do that, and it was cool. You know, January's coming up, and she had told me that she was really looking for a good tracking device to be able to start, you know, running and walking more. And, you know, she was the same size shoe as me. I'm a size 10. And she's like, you don't really see a lot of people selling, you know, nice shoes that are a size 10, that are our size. And I was like, yeah. So that was day one. And at the bottom here, it says, if you found yourself struggling, consider reviewing week 5. You might return to the section on barriers and see if any of them apply. If so, review possible ways to remove barriers. In the coming week, continue to follow the plan for listing, prioritizing, and scheduling your tasks. It can take repeated attempts to push through avoidance and start being more productive. Practice being patient with yourself as you find what works for you. Be patient with yourself, Regina. Be patient with yourself. Any of my subscribers or anyone that comes past this channel, I know that it's hard for me to, like, my self-talk can be negative at times. And remember, I believe it was in week 5 where he was saying, week 4, where he was telling Alex, like, how would you talk to a friend? If this friend made a mistake or was feeling guilty about something, like, how would you talk to her? And wouldn't it be nice if you could talk to yourself like that? So that's something that I'm really challenging myself, and, like, not being so down on myself, not being so hard on myself. And the crazy thing is I have the Headspace app and the wake up, as they call it, because in the morning they have, like, breathe for 1 minute, and then they have, like, the wake up where they discuss a certain topic. It was about perfectionism, and it discussed the 3 types of perfectionism and what that can do just to your mental, and how to try to overcome that, and how to be nicer to yourself. Because when you are, you know, a perfectionist, sometimes you overly worry about what people think, reputation, and you're very hard on yourself. And so when you make mistakes, for me, for example, like in my faith life, when I make a mistake, even if it's a mistake that nobody else knows about, you know, but it's a shortcoming that I know about, my dialogue with myself is not that of a friend, not even that of a Christian friend. Like saying, you know, we all sin, or we all struggle with things. You've got this. It's okay. Next time you'll do better. I'm more of like, oh man, you know, low key in the back of my mind, I'm like, I've disappointed God. So I really can take it to the extreme, and I'm really going to work on being patient with myself and just not being so judgmental of myself, and not, you know, letting those shortcomings bring me down or bring me low. So yeah, that was day 1. And like I said, I've done day 2, but I'm going to save that for another video. Thank you so much for, like, walking with me through this. It keeps me motivated, and it just keeps me doing this work. And it's progress. I can feel progress. Like, if you've been practicing having negative thoughts for 30 years, you know, I'm 39, so let's just say 20 years or 21 years that you've had negative thoughts, or your entire life. You know, I've tended to be this way my entire life. I'm not going to be able to just change it in 7 weeks. I have to actually practice and be conscious of it until it becomes, you know, easier and easier, or until I'm able to face those challenges, you know, with more confidence. Just like in running, I never started off at like a 9-minute pace. I started off at like a 16-minute average pace, and I had to keep going, and I had to keep practicing. Now I see the progress 3 years later, you know. So let's get into Let That Go. I've done this book a lot, so I'm not going to go through all the work that I've done, because like I said, I wanted to keep this video short. Oh, this was a good one. So this was December 26th, and it says, spin cycle. The world spins pretty damn fast, and it can be easy to get caught up in the whirlwind of things to do and stress about it. If you're the type of person who feels guilty just staying in bed past your alarm, me, Not having a jam-packed schedule or not moving at a speedy clip all day, take a breather. Or if you feel guilty because you hear your kids in the background, you know, fussing and tussling, and you're continuing to film this video. Take the time you feel this. Okay, the next time you feel this urge, halt that terrestrial rotation and let the stress move around you. How can you take a moment to slow the hell down? By not feeling guilty about sleeping in or not moving, by not feeling guilty about getting this video done because it was on my list of planned activities. And then the next one says, how can you make a habit of it? By telling myself I've done nothing wrong, to just relax and just to take it easy. Relax. That's another thing I pray often. I'm like, Lord, I do not know how to relax, like, or take it easy. Like, I do, but then again, I don't. So that's something that I definitely am like, just relax. It's not that big a deal. It's not that serious. Chill. Just relax. Jesus says, come away with me. I'll show you how to take a real rest. You know? So I hope that you enjoyed this video. I will be trying to get more of week 6 out to you guys this week, so that when I start week 7, we can just power through it. Like I said, I have chosen the new books, that the new workbooks that we're going to be journeying through. And they are two books that I've actually done in the past, about 15 years ago, maybe 14 or 15 years ago. But I thought that it would be awesome to revisit it because it's on a topic that I'm very, very passionate about. And these books really did help me overcome that situation. So I thought it would be nice to revisit it. So I'm looking forward to sharing that with you. And I think I'm gonna just film a video just to talk about why I chose these books and to give you all a trigger warning as well, in case that is, you know, the topic is too serious and it's triggering for you. That'll give you the opportunity to choose whether or not you want to go along on the journey with me. But thank you guys so much for your love and support. It means so much to me. Thank you to my subscribers. Thank you to my most recent subscriber. It really motivated me to go ahead and sit down and film a week 6 update because, you know, someone out there is enjoying the content. So thank you guys so, so much. Thank you for coming on this journey with me. And I definitely suggest copping these two books if, you know, that is, if it's something that you're really interested in, because it has helped me and it's went by fast. I mean, I know at first when I saw 7 weeks and then I saw this, I was like, this book is thick, but you know, we've crushed it and we're getting through and we're basically done. You know, we got week 7 to go. So I have day 7 of week 6 to finish. I'll do that tomorrow and then I'll be starting week 7. So we've made it through, but thank you so, so much. And like I said, I hope that this holiday season went well for you. I hope you did get to experience some joy. And if you didn't, it is okay. And if you're not feeling your best self, that's okay. It's not about how you start, it's about how you finish. Whether it's how you start your day versus how you finish it, or how you started out in life and how you're gonna finish your race. So thank you so much to you guys for your love and support. I greatly appreciate it. I love you guys. Thank you so much. And I will see you on the next video. Oh, and don't forget, you matter. What you want matter. What you feel matters. What you think matters. You matter.